All right, week three, Miscreant Hour.
Podcast, was it number three now?
Yep, number three.
Third week doing this.
Insane. GrindFactor.com, Mr. Skag here.
And Mr. Blue.
That's it. Sipping on some delicious coffee. And we were talking about earlier how I got a call from one of my buddies, Mr. Blue and I grew up with, went to high school with him. Yeah, great dude, always an awesome guy. And, he's a doctor now, right? Yeah,
yes, he's a doctor.
He's an official doctor.
And he's getting married as well.
Yeah, he's getting married. So, and I was totally happy for him, but it made us think how when people in your life that you grow up with end up being super successful, yeah, you know, yeah. doing really well for yourself.
Right.
And you, how do I put this?
Are just not
so successful. Kind of like makes you feel like shit.
Shit, yeah, shit, yeah, just the word.
Kind of makes you feel like an asshole. As happy as you are for him, like I'm totally stoked for him. Guy, he's like a brilliant engineer.
Yeah, you know what? And he's really one guy who really deserves it.
Yeah, he absolutely does.
You can say that without any bullshit in your voice.
Yeah, no,
you
know he really did. Yeah, he absolutely has. He's always
worked
hard.
Tremendously nice guy.
Yeah, he's really cool. Super fucking smart. He's got a doctorate in like engineering. I've read some of his research or attempted to read it about particle physics and fucking windmills and alternative energy and all this crazy shit that he just like.
And dude, he makes Facebook posts about that kind of shit too. And I'm like, dude, I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yeah, he's like on another world. He does conferences, he does lectures at different colleges all around the country. He teaches his own classes. Guy's name is fucking doctor. When I see him, I gotta call him doctor. I'm not calling him fucking doctor.
No, fuck that.
Fuck that.
He'll suck my dick.
Yeah, fuck him. and so he called me, and because he knew I'd just gotten out of jail, he wanted to see who, you know, how I was doing, typical nice guy fashion. And, you know, of course he was talking to me about him getting married. He told me to save the date. And basically, in so many words, he was like, yo, you better not be in jail when I get married, because I want you to be in a wedding. I'm like, I'll do my best.
Can I be your date? Because I don't think he invited me.
You didn't get invited?
No, I didn't get invited.
He didn't call you and tell you about it?
Nah, he didn't call me.
Wow.
No.
Oh, that makes me feel a little better.
Yeah.
That makes me feel slightly
He thinks
better.
A lot less of me than he does of you.
Okay, I like that. I like where we're going with this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but even in high school, the dude was Mr. Perfect. Got all the girls. Dude, he's a state wrestling champion.
Yeah, state wrestling champion.
I don't think he was ever defeated.
No, he can't.
I don't think he ever lost.
No, he would take down.
Not sure about the states or not, but no. I know like the regular season matches. He never lost.
No, he killed it. He was great. Really down to earth. After high school, he kind of went to the more like bohemian style thing. Got into engineering and science. And his brother's mad successful. He's like a fucking, you know, tech genius over in California. His whole family is just next level. Yep. So it made me think. It's like, man, I'm so happy for him. But like, what the fuck? Like, where did I go wrong? I just got out of jail, convicted felon, trying to stay clean. Dealing with life craziness on every fucking level. And he's just out there, you know, killing it. You know, he's a professor, for God's sakes. He's a fucking science genius getting married.
This man succeeds at everything he does.
Yeah, it's unreal. Although I will say this, his soon-to-be wife is like, she's old. She's like 10 years older than with two fucking kids.
She is.
Which is crazy.
But knowing him, because he can get any girl he wants.
That's a fact.
This guy, I really believe he must really fucking love her.
That's just he's just such a good guy that he doesn't even care about that. He's not even looking for like a 22-year-old like blonde bombshell.
Yeah, he's
totally
had it all
content.
At this point.
Yeah, he's completely content with like a nice down to earth older woman with two kids, and he lives over in fucking Illinois in like a cornfield, and he works at the university, you know, giving lectures on physics and engineering. It's out of control. So I know this is an issue for a lot of people. So sound off in the comments below. Did you know somebody? Do you know somebody who's super successful and kind of makes you feel like shit, as happy as you are for them, but it puts your life into perspective. You're like, man, what the fuck am I doing with my life?
Yeah, like when I'm around him, I don't feel like I'm good enough to clean his toilet. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like shit because he's so fucking good at everything.
Yeah, but you know what? I will give him this. He didn't start using heroin at fucking 14 years old. I did, partly for maybe why I ended up here and why he ended up there. Just saying.
Yeah, but I didn't, and I'm not fucking successful at all. I mean, I got a good job.
Yeah.
I work, but I'm still within that employership.
Yeah. You do also happen to be a raging alcoholic, though, so that could account for some of your life misgivings.
And my anxiety issues that are fucking off the wall. Mm-hmm. I think that counts for some things. Because I had a hard time in school. I'd go in college and doing reports and stuff. I'd have these awful anxiety attacks. I couldn't finish the reports. So that kind of stopped me from finishing up college.
Yeah.
So that kind of fucked me.
Well, that's the thing. Like, we've all had, you know, roadblocks in our life and issues that, you know, screwed us up or put us back a little bit. And, you know, even people who seem perfect, like, you know, our friend, he would be the first to admit that he's far from perfect. But I guess it's all, like, relative, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Compared to my life and everything that I've been through and what I'm going through right now. And we're around the same age, so it's just like he went one way and I went a completely different way.
Yeah, it's just different lives, period. And you can't, you shouldn't go around comparing yourself to anybody.
Yeah, that's, you know what I mean? Yeah, that's
because, you know, I've had a lot of fucking fun in my life and I wouldn't trade it for the world, you know? Mm-hmm. And I have good things going for myself. Am I going to be as successful as him? No. But you know what? I'm okay with that.
Yeah, that's what it comes down to. Some kind of level of acceptance where, yeah, maybe I've done some crazy shit and I've had a lot of bad times, but I've also had a lot of good ones, learned a lot about the world, seen things and done things that most people will never, ever experience. And in a way, kind of grateful for that. You know, I knew I know I was never going to live the kind of white picket fence lifestyle, you know what I mean? I just knew that wasn't in the cards for me.
Yeah, and you probably wouldn't want that. Would you want that?
I don't think
so. At this point in your life, I'm sure you probably don't.
I think I'd be bored as shit, honestly. Yeah, dude, I think I would be bored.
I'd be like two steps away from the gun cabinet every night.
Yeah.
Just think about putting that revolver in my mouth.
yeah, exactly. You living know? That kind of like ho-hum life, like the marriage, the kids,
greasing
a nice
the
house.
Trigger, just staring at it.
Just waiting to end it all.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, it happens. You can't help but not think about these things. You know what I mean? It's the more you hear of, like, friends getting married, having kids. I mean, dude, how many people do we know right now that have had kids that are getting married or have gotten married?
A lot.
I mean, a shitload. Every fucking day I feel like I hear about somebody new who's gotten married or who's doing this or doing that.
Oh, yeah. Look at my dumb Facebook wall. Like, I see,
right?
An engagement, a marriage, a child.
Yeah, like, Jesus fucking
it's
Christ.
Like, fuck, you know what? I'm just glad it's not me.
Yeah.
I'm just so fucking happy I'm not the one getting married. I'm not the one having a kid because I don't want one. At least not now.
Certainly not right fucking now. That would be all I need right now.
Dude, I'm having a blast being single, actually. I think I finally accepted that, like, you know what? I might not find love.
Mm.
And that's cool. I mean, I can survive on my own. I don't need a chick in my life.
Aww.
Trust me, there's no bitterness in my tone.
Yeah,
right now.
He's not bitter at all. Nothing at all. Everything he's saying is coming right from the absolute truth.
Yeah, I really think this.
Seriously.
Wink, wink.
He's not covering up any any
not
hidden
at all.
emotions.
Our bad experiences, no.
Yeah, no. Everything is totally fine. He's fine. So, in a way, other people's success can kind of make me almost, it's almost kind of like natural ambition where, you know, some people are the type to hear about somebody else's success and all they do is envy them and say, fuck you, you know, yeah, why do you have that and why don't I? But to me, that's like, first of all, there's some things that I don't want, like we were just talking about, where I don't care that you have that because I wouldn't want that anyway. But other things like, you know, successful job or just having money or whatever, that makes me want to work harder and go get those things,
yeah.
You know? If you have something that I want, I'm not going to hate you for it. You know, I'm going to be like, okay, cool, good for you. Now I'm going to go get that myself.
Yeah, I don't like irrational anger.
No, there's no sense in that. There's no sense in that. You end up coming off like an asshole.
Because you are.
Because you are an asshole.
Because you would be.
Yeah, you would be. Yeah, if that's how you view things, you know, if you can't be happy for anybody else and all you're doing is constantly wondering why someone has this and they have that and you don't have shit, well, it's probably because you have that kind of fucking attitude.
Yeah,
that's why. How are you going to succeed with that kind of outlook?
Trust me, most of the time, the people that do have that shit, they fucking earned it.
Yeah, that's another thing that really bothers me. A lot of people have this misconception that everybody out there that has something that they don't have, they didn't earn it. They it just fell out of the fucking clouds.
And you have a bunch of people, especially the younger generation that we sort of fall into, that feel entitled to have everything that they want. The job that they want.
The
car that they want.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they thought they would have it like that, like a snap of the finger, but they don't. They're finding that you actually have to work.
Yeah, it actually takes hard work. And they're pissed about it. They have this, like you said, this like supreme sense of entitlement where they're like, why don't they get a new job and they expect to be promoted to fucking CEO after like a month? It's
exactly.
Like, guess what? It doesn't work that way, you little shit. That's just not how the fucking world works. It'd be nice. But Unfortunately, you have to work really hard for good shit.
And I think by complaining and envying other people's successes, it'll magically fall in their lap? Yeah. Is that what they think?
I think so. You know what? It goes towards, and we could tie this back into the whole addiction thing too, towards that instant gratification. A lot of people have that desire. They want instant gratification. They want what they want, and they want it right fucking now. Yeah. And I feel like a lot of times when I stumble with getting clean or anything, it's because I want to get clean and I want to be better now.
Yeah.
And I want it right this second.
You just don't
want
to work
for it. I don't want to work for it. For the sobriety. Yeah, exactly. Knowing that, like, of course, like, anything worthwhile requires effort and requires a shitload of work.
Yeah. Because it won't be easy.
No, it's like, look, you didn't fuck up your life in 2 seconds. You're not going to get better in 2 seconds. You know what I mean? Like, it takes fucking time, both sides. So now you got to come out of it, and it takes just a lot of serious effort. And a lot of people aren't willing to put in that effort.
No. I don't think a lot of these kids these days are really capable of learning work ethic. And they had no desire to or just try or put in that kind of
effort. They didn't grow up with any kind of work ethic instilled in them. And a few of them did, and those are the ones that really make it, but a lot of them didn't.
Yeah, of course, not saying everybody, but I mean, it seems like the vast majority do not. They don't have any kind of instinct or desire to work to achieve things.
Yeah, and that impacts every aspect of your life. I mean, work ethic, obviously, it impacts, like, your job and how successful you are going to be in your career, whatever you're doing, but it also goes to your relationships, you know, and how much work those take, you know what I mean? And the marriage rate is fucking a disaster. A lot of people have tons of different girlfriends that can't be with someone for more than a little bit of time, and as soon as things start getting rocky, they call it quits. They're fucking out, you know, because everyone's got baggage, everybody has shit, and obviously, you know, in the beginning of relationships, everything's fucking la-di-da, and it's all beautiful, and you're in lust, and you're fucking all the time, and everything's great, but after a little while, that little lust pink cloud period ends, and then, to make it work, it puts, you know, requires some serious fucking effort.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, a lot of people are like, alright, I'm done.
Especially with people's attention spans these days, they can't even watch, like, a 30-second clip without getting bored.
There's just too much out there. Your mind is just filled with shit, and you forget about what's important, like real human interaction, you know what I mean? Yeah. Sitting down with your significant other, with one of your buddies, and actually talking and chilling out and, you know, being in the now. You know, too many people, they always think about the past and in the future, and what if this happens, and what if this didn't happen, what would I be now, where would I be now? And I say, fuck that. I don't like that mentality. I want to live in the now. I want to live here. It's obviously still good to have an eye on the future, but I want to think about things that I can change right now. Not what happened in the past, not what might happen right now.
Yeah, and I think people want everything just to be an instant orgasm.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean?
God, I would love an instant orgasm.
They don't want to do the foreplay and build up to it.
No, and unfortunately, as we know, a foreplay makes the orgasm that much better.
That much better.
You can't just skip the foreplay. I mean, come on.
You can. It's essential.
That's a good, I'm going to fucking make a bumper sticker over that. Don't skip the foreplay of life.
But it's like, and that's why they're constantly looking for visual stimuli from anything. That's why people, they're walking around like the city with their faces burying their cell phone.
I hate those fucking people.
They can't miss anything. Everything has to be right then, there, now. And, you know, if it's not good enough, where's the next thing? They're always looking for it with that orgasm. You know, they don't want to work for anything.
No.
Everything has to be right there. They really just don't want it.
Yeah, they get tired of it. They get bored of it. And like we said, they're not willing to put in the fucking effort to keep it, you know, to keep these good things from happening. They have all these ideas for what they want their future to be. But once they realize how much work it actually takes to get to that point, they're like, screw it.
Yeah, fuck that.
Yeah, screw that now. I'm going to, you know, strive for something way more attainable, which is, you know, it's not good. You shouldn't settle. You know what I mean?
No. I don't know why anyone would. I mean, you have one life, YOLO.
Yeah, seriously.
Are you kids, YOLO? That's you only live once?
That's a fact, really. As corny as that shit sounds, that is true, man. Like, you really only live once. And I don't know about anybody else out there, but I don't want to spend that life constantly in fear of what might happen or not going for something because it requires too much work.
Yeah.
You know, I say, fuck it. Go for your dreams. Go for what you want to do. You know, put some real effort into something. And forget what might happen. Just do it and hope for the best.
Yeah, I think fear is a big detractor.
Yeah, absolutely.
As well as self-doubt. not actually thinking you can attain what that what it is that you want.
Yeah, Syria, having self-esteem issues, not believing that you're that you can actually get it, and like you said, the fear of failure.
Yeah.
Fear of putting your all into something and having it not work out.
Because failure naturally makes you pretty vulnerable.
Yeah, you absolutely. Know? You feel like shit, you start doubting yourself. You know, I've gone through this many times with relationships, and part of the reason why a lot of times I'll stay in a relationship with a girl that I know is doomed and I know is not working is because I don't want to have invested all this time into something and then have it be over and be like, fuck, now I got to start all over again. What was that all for?
You don't want to invest that time into something that you actually think could work because it would feel that much worse when it
fails. May not. Exactly, when it may not. But that's what we were talking about before. Thinking about making choices in the present based on what might happen in the future. And that's no way to fucking live. That's just no way to live, you know? And when I find myself thinking that way, I try and check myself right away. Because if you're constantly worried about, you know, what are you going to do? Not drive a car because you're worried that you might crash one day? That's no excuse not to do it. You know what I mean? Like, you still have to go for it. You still have to live your life. You can't just live in a box, in a little bubble your whole life, afraid to do anything because something might happen in the future that doesn't work out.
Yeah, right.
Why would you want to live that way? But so many people do, and it impacts their life in every fucking way.
Yeah, where it's just, I don't know, everyone's so, like, I feel like everyone just kind of lives in their own little pod in a way, because you can get everything delivered to you.
Mm-hmm.
You can watch your favorite TV shows, your movies. You don't have to leave the house. You really don't have to leave the house. I mean, you can get your groceries delivered to your house nowadays, you know?
Yeah, you can get anything delivered. You can call down on the deli and get a toothbrush and a fucking sandwich delivered right up to your apartment.
Like, kind of going back to my little pod analogy thing, I feel like eventually there probably will be a pod that you can lay in, and it can literally take you, you can have sex with the hottest girl, and you can feel that actual sensation in your pod.
Yeah, but you're really just laying in a fucking...
In a fucking pod.
Jesus, man. Well, if there was one of those out
but
right now, I would
buy it right now.
But you'll
think you're fucking a supermodel.
Wow, I would take that. I would lay in a pod.
It'll feel like you're fucking a supermodel, but you won't actually be, but, you know, it'll be very, like, Matrix-y.
Well, you know what? Put me in the pod right now. If they were to say this is a Matrix, if you go in this little pod, you'll have a great life and you could just fantasize whatever you fucking want.
Would you do it?
I said, sign me the fuck up.
Yeah.
life is too fucking crazy. But at the same time, it's like I like the uncertainty of life. You know what I mean? I kind of get a thrill on the whole. This might not work out. Like this might end in complete disaster and in total flames.
Yeah, probably will.
Probably will. A lot of things do. But you know what? On the off chance that it won't, it'll be pretty fucking awesome. And at least you have known that you went for it and threw caution to the wind and tried. You gotta try.
Eradicate fear in yourself.
Yeah, I feel like this is like a self-help podcast. Yeah. Now. We're like fucking Doc. We're like who? Tony fucking Rob. But it's fact. It's true. It's true shit right there. And, you know, to bring it home to more specific things, like, think about it in, like, your specific day. Like, if you're trying to get clean or if you're in a relationship that's not working out, you know, which one of you or are you both or are just you, you know, worried about what might happen? You're not giving it your fucking all. And you're just content to live in this, like, you know, gray area of, like, just mediocre, you know? Fuck that. Yeah. I say either go big or just totally go home.
I kind of agree with that because, you know, I've been living mediocre for many years and within certain situations, and I can tell you it's not fun. I mean, mediocre isn't fun compared to when you get that what you really want.
Yeah, exactly.
Getting what you really want always is going to beat mediocre.
Right. So sometimes, like, when you live in, like, the extreme, unfortunately, look, and I would rather this, and I've told my girlfriend this a few times because she's the type of girl who would always think about the future and wonder what might happen, and that would impact what she did in the present. And I would say, you know, I don't want to live that way. I would rather have a relationship or have a life where it's either extremely amazing or terribly bad and just bland in the middle.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to do that. I don't want to just live a bland, mediocre, safe life. I'll take the extreme highs and the extreme lows over that any day.
Right. Two girlfriends ago, for me personally, I was living in the mediocre.
Yeah, you were just scrounging right in the mid zone.
God, I remember, like,
you're on midfield,
dude. Like, she was a vet tech, and she just worked all these crazy hours and stuff, and we never could hang out. And when we did, we were just fucking sitting on the couch, just doing stupid thing after stupid thing, hang out with her friends who I hated, and they hated me.
So it was bland as shit, right?
Yeah, I remember, like, just laying in bed, after she went, I mean, I remember coming home from work, like, because she'd have these weird mental breakdowns from work, like, stress and all that, where we left a couple, like, 2 weeks in a row or more where we wouldn't fuck.
Ugh.
I remember coming home from work tired. I just loved to have a nice lay, you know what I mean?
And she was not having it.
And fucking not having it. And I remember, like, going, like, laying there at night, staring up the ceiling, like, what the fuck am I doing?
Yeah, right.
Why am I in this relationship?
I need to get the fuck out of here.
Why am I doing this to myself? Why? Why do I even love her? I don't love her. Sweet, I don't think I love her.
Awesome internal monologue. Did you call it quits then?
No, I stayed for another
season. Jeez, what are we talking about? Why the fuck would you stay? Gotta make the choice. Fuck it. Do it.
It's those moments when you should just fucking put on your pants and leave.
Yeah, no, literally. And sometimes literally, exactly, put on your pants and leave. I think I should have done that many times in my life. I would have been saved a lot of trouble had I have just done that.
Exactly. Fuck that. Fuck living. Fuck being in a relationship like that. Fucking sucks.
Yeah, it's horrible. It's fucking miserable. And all of you out there living miserable lives or in miserable relationships or just doing something that you fucking hate, fuck that.
Exactly.
Do what you fuck have to it. Do to change your goddamn situation, for fuck's sake, you know? Ugh, just handle your business. Seriously not worth it, because then time flies. It goes by so goddamn fast. It goes by faster every year.
Yeah, getting her cat's hair all over you, fucking waking you up at night, fuck that.
Yeah, so yeah, he's clearly got no issues about this relationship anymore. He's Well, at least it's over now. Seriously, fuck women like that. Yeah. Fuck relationships like that. Ugh. I have no time for that crap.
No, not anymore. Fuck. All right, so what else can we talk about now?
I don't know. I'm sipping on this cup of coffee right now. Dude,
that was a great cup of coffee, man.
French vanilla creamer, bro. That's a secret.
You got that fucking monster machine up there. That makes a good cup of coffee.
Yeah, the steamer. You can steam that cup of coffee.
You can taste the difference. I mean, from my little, like, Mr. Coffee at home.
I make coffee like a fucking boss. No, I don't play around, dude. I really don't play around. We're going to start selling Grind Factor official coffee.
Yeah, we should make our own, like, coffee beans and sell the grounds.
Yeah, each coffee bean's going to be in the shape of, like, a little miniature syringe, and you just grind that up and drink it and...
Yeah, shoot in your fucking...
All right, so bringing around to get the topic a little back on track. You know about that Snapchat shit that's going on?
Oh, it's called the League of the Photos, right? They're called
The Snapping. Oh my god, that shit is fucking out of control.
Oh boy, that's scary.
Snapchat, right? Okay, let me ask you this right off the bat. How many dick pictures now are you worried about being leaked online? How many of them are out there?
I'm thinking probably close to 80.
So, you heard that first. 80 dick pics, Mr. Blue, are floating around online now because of the Snapchat.
Yeah, there's a good chance you can see my cock if you go look for it now.
Oh my god, that shit is out of control. I thought that shit was supposed to be secure. They were supposed to be deleted as soon as you sent them.
Supposedly, but no.
Wow, unbelievable. Just goes to show that you really cannot trust shit.
Yeah, and you shouldn't anyway. I mean, even though they had that guarantee, was ever promised or guaranteed, but...
I don't know. I thought that was like the whole...
I know that's what the whole thing was built around, but like...
I know, I've used it to talk about some scandalous shit in the past, you know what I mean? I know a lot of people have, thinking it was secure. I mean, I always wondered about it.
Yeah.
Because I don't trust any of that shit.
You never really should.
Exactly. As soon as you put something out online, it's there, whether they claim it gets deleted or not. Just goes to show that they were totally full of shit. Yeah. I think they're claiming it's not their fault. Whoops. Basically just a big whoops. Them. Like, oh, sorry. All of your
Too
shit.
Bad.
All of your shit and dick pics and tit shots have been leaked all over the internet. My bad.
I've got some embarrassing shots on there.
Oh, my God. They're like the BP oil of, like, social networking and online.
Yeah, I think I've sent a couple of videos to chicks. Like, this chick in Ireland, right? I was kind of drunk. Well, I met her here in the States. She was an au pair. Mm-hmm. Once again.
God, man. Love, you love the au pairs, don't you?
And, when she went back to Ireland, we kind of kept in contact through Snapchat primarily, just like texting and stuff. So I was drunk one night, and she was with a friend and stuff. She's, you know, trying to like get me to do something stupid.
Mm-hmm.
And I ended up sending her like a video of me naked, like shaking my dick around on it.
What are you, meat spinning for?
Meat spinning for, essentially.
Oh, no.
Oh, how embarrassing.
Oh, my God. That's out there. That's up somewhere. That's probably on YouPorn right now.
Oh, fuck.
That is out of control. That's like a serious flop. What they said, just read the article, they said 13 gigabytes of images and shit have been leaked from like 10,000 accounts. That is like...
that's a lot, the gigabytes.
Oh my God, think about one picture. It's like a few fucking megabytes.
Right.
Like 13 gigabytes. That's like a fucking hard drive's worth. Jeez, that's like a whole iPhone's worth of shit.
Fuck.
Oh man, there's gonna be some pissed off people out there.
Oh yeah. I hope... I'm pretty sure I kept my face out of all of them. I think I did. Not sure.
Wow. Depends how recognizable your dick is in and of itself. It's like, oh, that's Mr. Blue's dick. I know it.
Yeah.
That's definitely him.
Oh, man. I think I might be wearing, like, if not, like, I could be, there's times I know I was wearing my headphones because I have my computer just chilling, listening to music or something that look horrible.
Oh, my God.
Oh, if I end up catching like, a little bit of my face with the headphones on in it.
Holy shit.
Like the studio headphones, man. That looks so stupid.
Naked with a pair of headphones.
Naked with a pair of headphones on.
It's an attractive look.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. You actually send those images out to girls? Jesus Christ.
Yep.
I don't think I've ever used Snapchat for that. I don't know if I've had naked pictures and shit, but I don't think I've ever used it for that. Other kinds of illicit activity, sure, but...
Oh, yeah.
I mean, not that. Yeah, well, you know, I think I never use it that much because I always kind of doubted it. I have friends that are always like, oh, you know, let's talk via Snapchat, yeah, you know, it's secure. I'm like, I don't fucking know. I'd rather
man, you're smart.
Yeah, I'd rather meet face-to-face or, like, whatever. I talk on, like, a prepaid, like, burner phone or something like that. But anything on, like, a regular phone is tied to anyone, tied to my name in any way, fuck that.
Yep.
You know, I just have no trust for that shit. I've known too many people to get burned like that.
Yeah.
And it's funny. Everyone always wonders, like, these big scandals come out, celebrities or whoever, friends... naked pictures or sex tapes gets leaked, and then other people just keep making them, and they're like, "Oh, that won't happen to me." It's like, what do you mean? It just happened It's happening all the time.
Yeah, but
yeah, people still do it.
What about Apple and this fucking iCloud thing?
Oh, the cloud.
I don't even know how it works. Like, I have an Apple phone, but I don't know what the fuck I have on my cloud, or what I don't have.
The whole
on my
concept
cloud.
Of the cloud is a little baffling.
It's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
How about you get fucking rid of the cloud?
Yeah, fuck the cloud.
I don't want to have a cloud.
Yeah, exactly. I don't like clouds. Fuck clouds.
No. Fucking cumulus. Fuck cumulus clouds and shit like that. Stratus, right?
I don't know. All I know is I don't fucking like it. And the idea of my information just like floating in like the abyss.
Yeah, I don't get it because it doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah, I can't wrap my head around it.
I don't get it.
I like things I can see. I will save shit to, like, a personal fucking hard drive that I keep, like, under the mattress. Like, old school people keeping their money under there.
So this shit must be, like, this... Apple have, like, a big mainframe, like, server. And that's what the cloud is. Everything's going on their server. And it's connected to your phone. And that's
I don't know. Anybody, any member who understands what the cloud is, please post about it. Because I have no fucking idea what it is. And trying to describe it, I'll probably just sound like an asshole. So if you know what it is, please inform us. Enlighten all of us.
I would actually like to know.
Talk about the cloud.
If you know something about it.
Yeah, so this whole thing kind of goes back to a prior point that we're making. And we've talked about before where there's just too much goddamn choice out right now. There's so many different apps and online sites and fucking products and everything that you can think of. There's 9,000 different variants and choices of it.
Yeah, you get bombarded from anywhere you look and turn.
Yeah, you really do. And there's this thing, I don't know if you heard about this, there's an actual term for it's called decision fatigue.
Wait, what's that about?
If you can believe that, I'm sure that's just like the PC fucking word for being overloaded.
Tired.
Too much shit. But they call it, now it's called decision fatigue, where... Yeah. Now you have, there's so much choice out there. There's so many fucking decisions that you have to make. Even like from big ones to tiny little ones, like what kind of candy bar you want to buy at the fucking checkout aisle.
Nope.
That your mind gets overloaded and it gets ridiculous. And you're not going to believe this. I was just reading this article and they said there was a study done at Columbia University they talked about the decision fatigue and how it applies to a workday. And they actually said that judges are more inclined to give favorable rulings in the beginning of the day than at the end of the day after they've had so many choices throughout the whole day, like what they're going to have for lunch, what they're going to do here, what they're going to do there. So at the end of the day, they're tired of all this decision making and they just fucking slay people.
Yeah.
No shit. Can you fucking believe that? So it's like, it impacts people in such crazy ways, and now it's like other people's decision fatigue could impact you because they're tired and they're pissed and they're annoyed.
That is fucking fucked up.
Yeah, and hear that. So, whichever one of you, last person that gets slayed on a case, you know, hopefully, you know, it was probably at the end of the day and the judge was pissed because he couldn't decide what kind of toilet brush to buy off of Amazon, which, by the way, the article quotes and says, Amazon sells over 1,000 different kinds of toilet brushes.
Can you imagine that?
sitting there for fucking 4 hours to pick out what kind of brush to wipe the shit out of your toilet bowl.
Why do you need that much variance in a toilet brush?
That's just what, it's insane. You can't even blame people for getting overloaded because not only do we have big decisions to make, like who to marry, you know, what job to take, this or that, like big life decisions, those are hard enough to think about in and of themselves, but then you get bombarded with all the little dumb shit.
Yeah.
You know, like, and everything is just, you just get overloaded. There's too much fucking, just too much shit to think about on a daily basis.
Yeah, that's not going to change. Even like any website you go to, having those pop-ups. And so you can't avoid it.
No.
From people trying to sell you things.
Yeah, exactly. You can't just go to one website and stay at that one website. You have to get bombarded by 50 other fucking different ones trying to grab your attention for even a split second. Literally, people are now, companies and everything is competing for literally just a snippet, one little fraction of a second of your time.
There's just more devices now that they can utilize to advertise to you.
Yeah, there's too many. And I think before, people think about what it was like before when you only had certain options. When you wanted to find something out, you had to go find a book on that, read it, and then that's how you would know. Now you just fucking search it on your phone. And so right now there's so much choice altogether that people are saying, and some of these studies being done are saying, that literally too much choice actually doesn't cause happiness, doesn't better your life, but literally causes unhappiness. Where the more choices you have, the more decisions you have to make, big and small, make you more unhappy.
I believe that because I can think, you know, with myself, when I'm tired, I'm not as happy. I don't like being tired. I don't like being worn out. I don't like to have to overthink about things.
Yeah, and today you constantly do. And literally having too much choice will often make people choose not to do anything at all. I can't tell you how many times I'm going online or surfing the web or watching TV and there's 9,000 channels. I can't pick what to watch, so I don't watch anything.
Yeah,
because there's just too much shit. I don't know what to pick. I don't know what to decide. I'd rather have four channels and then just pick one of the four.
And by the way, if you made a note, or some kind of graph of like what you actually watched, it probably would literally, like you said, it probably would be like four channels.
Yeah, people don't, exactly.
There's probably channels, you could probably weed out what you don't actually watch.
Yeah, easily.
Which would be the vast majority of them, you know?
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be nice to only just pay for what you watched?
I know, and I think some cable companies are like, or some special services are claiming that they do that, but from what I've seen, you either choose to get everything or nothing. You know what I mean? Like, you can't just
these criminal prices.
Yeah, for everything. You know, you just can't fucking win. You know, I don't need that much choice. You know, I have enough struggle in my day thinking about huge life decisions that I don't want to have to worry about, you know, which toilet brush to buy off Amazon. I don't give a fuck what it is. I don't care. You know, like, there's too many things to just occupy your mind, and you end up wasting all your thought power on insignificant shit.
Yeah, that's very true.
And it tires you out. You know what I mean? Like, And then once the big decisions come and dealing with things that are important, you're tired from a whole day of making meaningless decisions that you just have 50 different fucking options
for. And then you inadvertently might make a really bad decision that will significantly impact your own life.
Yeah, exactly. Instead of taking all the small decisions and being like, fuck it, these aren't even worth thinking about. Once the big decisions come, like you said, you're exhausted.
You drop the ball.
You drop the ball and you do something stupid. You know, and you make a horrible choice that could seriously impact your life. That's just how it is.
Yeah. And I think maybe we could just try to, like, at least now that you know that, or you're thinking about, the more you think about it, the more you're going to adjust accordingly, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe limit the amount you surf the web or look at your cell phone, watch TV. I don't know what else you can really do. You know, do you have any ideas?
You know what, see? Right now, I'm faced with decision fatigue. I'm thinking about all the things we could talk about in this podcast, and now my mind is like fucking burnt out.
I'm tired.
So the option is, fuck this podcast. I'm going to turn it off right now because I can't decide what to talk about.
Yeah.
The same thing. Like, there's so many fucking things out there. My mind, you get tired from just thinking. Like, your mind just starts to fucking hurt from existing in this society that just has so much shit going on at all times. It's like, God, sometimes I just want to lock myself in a quiet room and think about nothing and stare up at the ceiling. And that's the most peaceful moment of my day.
or read a book and relax.
Oh my god, I love that shit.
It's fucking amazing.
Yeah, reading is like, look, I've always loved reading. When I was in jail, I read a ton of fucking books. Like, the quiet times during, like, lock-in were, like, my favorite times of the day. Because it got so crazy in there, and everything was so loud, and everybody was so nuts, that the times when we were just locked in our cell, like, chilling out, was the best. Because I could finally just be quiet and relax and think or read a book. And that shit, like, saved my fucking life. That, like, you know, gave me some sanity.
I bet.
Some clarity, which you seriously need in there.
Had that some like a moment of escape from dealing with those animals.
And yeah, that's really what it is. Like every moment of escape is like gets you gold. Gets you through the next fucking few hours. Sometimes that's all it takes. They go one day at a time, but sometimes you gotta live 1 minute at a time because things get so crazy and so exhausting that literally you're going second by second just to not snap.
Yeah. Did we have we talked about your jail stories yet? Oh, did we or did we touch that in the first podcast or
I don't think so. I mean, it was just
can't remember.
Stories wise, I don't know. I've talked about it with a few people on Grind Factor. It was just, you know, craziness, typical craziness. Like, you know, it wasn't Shawshank Redemption, but it was certainly not fun. I'll put it that way. You know, so a lot of fights, got into a few fights. And what's the weirdest thing about it in there is like it's got its own like barter system. Where it's got, it's like a little microcosm, like an exaggerated microcosm of life, where like people will get like a phone cracked over their head because they owe somebody two soups worth a dollar.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That becomes like paramount, like trading soups and cigarettes, like it's got its own fucking currency. And, you know, there's some people that have been there for a long time and aren't going to see the outside again for like a very, very long time. So they just don't give a fuck. You know, they don't care.
Yeah, and I don't know why they have you guys with them. Yeah, that's kind of stupid.
Yeah, the only people that they usually tried to segregate were, like, the pedophiles and the kitty touchers and shit, because they would get the shit kicked out of them every time anybody saw them. But everybody else was all together. State inmates, county inmates, like, there's even, you know, Fed inmates who were, you know, about to go do Fed time somewhere at some Big Macs fucking, you know, Fed Correctional Center. It was just, you know, it was insane.
You should tell the story when you broke that fucker's hand.
Oh.
When I stomped on his hand.
Yeah, that was the first... No, that was the second week that I was in there, and people have been coming up to my cell and shit, and, you know, coming up to me on the block, asking for, like, my fucking food, my commissary, and cigarettes, and shit like that. So I said, no, fuck you, you know what I mean? I wasn't giving anybody anything. And so I was walking by the showers one day, and, like, a lot of people fighting there because there's no cameras and shit, and this dude, like, this fucking big guy, he walked by, and, like, he just, like, bump-checked me into the shower. So I go flying in the shower, I hit the fucking tile wall. He comes in swinging. I hit him a few times, whatever. We scrap it out. He ends up on the floor. And I'm going to walk away because, you know, I don't want to get any too much attention. I was only in there for a few months. I didn't want to get in a big fight, catch a new charge, and be in there for fucking years. So I wanted to get the hell out of there. So then he goes to grab my ankle as I'm walking away. And you know how I get. Like, I just sometimes like, snap. I get, like, really fucking angry. So I stomped on his hand, like, a good four or five times and broke, like, all the bones in his hand. Like, it was... You know, his hand looked like a fucking, like, mushed up, like, piece of fruit by the time I was done. And he was in a cast for a while afterwards and shit. And thankfully, after that, nobody fucked with me. So, it was all good. I had no problems, even with him when he came back.
Yeah.
But, it was just, it was like an opening to just, like, a whole time of just complete fucking craziness. And I saw way worse after that. Other people got way more jacked up than that dude did. It was just insane. I was in there trying to, like... hold on to home and think about getting back out, and at the same time trying to like live in the moment there and not think about it because it makes it harder to be there. And then when I got out, you have to deal with everybody either thinking you're a piece of shit or expecting you to now live your life one way, you live your life this way, and now you have to be super clean, you have to do this, you can't touch this, you can't touch that, and it's just, like, the stress gets fucking overwhelming, you know?
Yeah.
Everybody has an idea for, like, what they want your life to be, and you weren't consulted on any of it. And now you have to live up to all these different people's expectations. And it gets to be, just like we said, just overwhelming. Another thing in life that's completely overwhelming.
Yeah.
So not only do I have to now deal with, like, just being clean and as difficult as that fucking is... Your girlfriend wants you to be the perfect boyfriend. Your parents want you to be the perfect son. Your job wants you to be the perfect employee. And, like, society wants you to be a model citizen. And you're just like, God, fuck all of you. You know what I mean? Like, when did everybody decide who I was supposed to be and who I wasn't supposed to be?
People can't help themselves, you know, they always got to give their 2 cents on everything, don't they?
Yeah, they really do.
Especially friends, family.
Yeah, and
even people that aren't really your friends.
And forget what you think about the whole thing. They have their opinion.
Why would they care about that?
Why would they?
But I'm also kind of curious about, I don't know if I asked you this already, but could you go to jail and just keep to yourself? Because I think if I had to go to jail, I'd want to just stay the fuck away from everybody. Just hang out. Like, I don't want to be friends. I don't want to join a gang.
Well, yeah, I mean...
Or do you kind of have to assimilate with the culture?
No, well, honestly, the best thing to do is kind of keep to yourself. There's only so much keeping yourself that you can do. At the same time, you have to think about, like, you're living in a space with, like, you know, 60 or 70 other dudes in very close proximity to each other, around each other 24/7. So there's really only so much keeping yourself that you can do. But the way to do it is really to just to not cause any trouble yourself. You know what I mean? If people say hi to you, say what's up, you keep walking.
Yeah.
Don't be loud. Don't fucking talk any shit. Don't try and be a jokester. That's the best way. And if you can find a few people who also kind of keep themselves and kind of look out for each other, that's make usually the best thing to do. Yeah. Too many people make the mistake of going in trying to be everybody's friend, and either you end up rubbing somebody the wrong way and getting your head split open, or everyone just starts taking advantage of you because you're trying to be friendly and you're giving people soup, and some people are borrowing cigarettes, and as soon as you do that one time,
yeah,
it's a wrap. People will be on your fucking doorstep the entire bit asking for all your shit. I saw people, their commissary would come in, within 2 hours they would be gone because everybody just lined up, took all their shit, and they didn't do anything about it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think the best thing to do is, yeah, keep to yourself, do your thing, don't rub anything the wrong way, but if something happens, you gotta be willing to handle it, take care of it, otherwise you're gonna have a rough time.
Yeah.
It's better to get into a fight right away and, you know, go downstairs for a little bit, spend some time in the box, than have an entire rest of your bid be miserable because people saw that you didn't stand up for yourself. That's really what it is. People get broken down to, like, their primal selves. It's just like you said, it's fucking animals. You know what I mean? The system breaks people down, and they want people to think that, like, they deserve to be there, and that it's almost better there, and that they can't function on the outside. They just break you down to, like, complete, like, your bare minimum. You know, they tell you what to do, when to do it. They walk by while you're taking a shit. You know, it's just like you have no privacy, you have no nothing. It's just, you're just like a number, you know. It's like, it's really, like, debasing, you know.
Yeah. I mean, I think they really should be, especially the people that are doing short time, they should be treating it like more of a rehabilitation kind of thing.
Mm.
And why treat you like animals? Why aren't they trying to provide some kind of, like, just at least change the culture, change, I mean, maybe it's easier said than done, I don't, you know.
Well, you know, I don't think they fucking want to, because I posted a news article where and some people started talking about in that thread, like, the prison industrial complex and the whole business of the whole thing. And the fact is, like, the corporations that own a lot of these prisons and a lot of these jails, you know, a lot of them aren't state owned. The private corporations who are, you know, who own these, the shareholders own them. And they make a lot of money from people coming back and forth, which is why they want people to be constantly filled in jails. They want you to go out and fuck up and come back in, you know. They want you, because all the labor, when you're in jail and you're in prison, you work for fucking free. You work for nothing. Making license plates, making clothes, making, you know, plastic lunchboxes, making military equipment. Tons of products out there that people would not even realize were actually made in prisons and jails for people getting paid fucking, you know, 5 cents a day. It's a huge, massive business, and they want to keep prisons filled. They want to keep the jails filled. As soon as one person leaves, they fill that cell right away. That's just how it is. So it's not about rehabilitation. They don't really want you to get better. They want you to be part of the system. They want it to be a revolving fucking door. And they want people in for longer, longer times.
Hmm.
You know, the whole mandatory minimums, those were created by the corporations and the unions of CEOs and all the people who make money off of people serving time in prison.
Yeah.
They're the ones behind the whole mandatory minimums, where people are getting guaranteed sentences of years in prison for bullshit.
That's fascinating. I never really knew that.
Yeah, that's how it works. I can't tell you how many people were in there for nonviolent drug crimes. Literally 80%. And the sickest thing, the sickest shit that I saw in there were pedophiles and rapists getting out earlier and having less bail than people in there for nonviolent drug crimes. There was a guy in there, he was 66 years old, he raped 3 3-year-olds and a 12-year-old.
Jesus.
His bail was less than a guy in there for selling 20 bags of crack. That's it. The guy had no gun, no nothing.
How does that happen?
And you know, what's fucked up is then the rapist got out. After he made bail, he got out. He raped another kid, got back in, and when he got sentenced, his sentence was, he was sentenced to 5 flat. The other guy, the drug guy, he had over 10 years.
Wow.
So yeah, wrap your mind around that fucking shit.
That's not fucked up. I don't know what is.
Yeah, it's sickening. It's absolutely sickening. You know, it's...
These are the kind of things that people just don't talk about.
You know, no, they don't talk about them. You know, they just pretend to leave things as they are.
They'd rather get all outraged and pissed off at meaningless things than some celebrity they liked said something they didn't like. They'd rather get all pissed off and make a big deal about that.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
They have these real issues in the world that no one's saying anything about.
Yeah, they'd rather bury their fucking face in Us Weekly and then realize what's going on. They have these misconceptions. Everyone thinks that everybody in prison and jail is a total piece of shit and a scumbag and... That's just not the case. Yeah, there's a few of them that are, but a lot of the people in there are good people, are really nice, genuine dudes who just made a wrong turn and ended up in the system and are now just totally wrapped up in it, you know, because they set you up for failure. You know, you leave, then you're on parole, you're on probation, where it's so strict, then you violate and you go back. You know, you can't get a job. Everyone looks at you like shit. You know, like, it's the system is set up that once you're in it, you're in it, and you just go back.
You come back.
Yeah, you just go back around and around in one big fucking circle, and that's just how it works. That's just how it works.
Damn, that sucks.
Real positive note we have going on right here with Miscreant Hour.
She's got to change. And what about another thing I was thinking about on my mind today? These outrageous toll booth prices for bridges.
Oh God, yeah. Anybody who lives in like the tri-state area, in New York, New Jersey. Are very familiar with
that
shit.
I think it's a Whitestone. I remember paying $5.50. I think it was $5.50 each way.
Yeah.
So let's say, you know, people go and work and come back, or, you know, fucking paying that both ways.
Yeah, the Port Authority and MTA are absolutely out of their fucking minds. That's for damn sure. The bridges, you know, it costs you fucking $15 to get back and forth on some of these goddamn bridges. The GW is like ridiculous.
And we're in like a recession right now, right?
Yeah, supposedly.
How can you justify that shit?
You know what? Because people don't do anything about it. You know, they just, like, the court on their side, why wouldn't they want to do that? They just make a ton of fucking money, and people just keep paying it like idiots.
I'd be curious to know what they make in one fucking day.
Oh, my God.
You do it for, like, bridge repairs and this and that, but, like, dude, they probably fucking make that money in a day. They fucking take care of it for, like, a year, probably.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know. I'm not an actuary, but, like, for fuck's sake.
I know. It is out of control. It's just
one
of the many
things.
I
mean, people really, like, these are things that I can't believe that, like, people haven't revolted about, you know?
You know what? It's way easier just to do nothing.
It is.
Unfortunately.
People, like, just like to take a dick in the ass.
I think they do.
Same with the gas prices. They just accept, that's just the way it is.
They just get fucked, and they're content to just continue to get fucked.
Yeah, the whole price is just the way it is.
Yeah,
no, fuck that.
people, unfortunately, everybody has the idea that, like, oh, what can one person do? What can I do to make a difference? But if everybody thinks that way, then nothing fucking gets done.
Yeah.
But if everybody individually was like, okay, I'm tired of this shit, then you'd end up having a movement, something that actually, you know, creates some change. But too many people are content to just deal with the hand that's given to them and take it.
Especially shit like that. Especially just like going back to the tolls. Like, you can't for a second justify that shit.
No, that's
you know?
For sure.
Gas prices, they can bullshit you. The price of the barrel is up because of this and that and blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
But they can't fucking bullshit you about the fucking bridges. You don't have to be an expert to know that you're getting fucked.
Yeah, I know. Fuck, I'm just going to start swimming across the Hudson River. Fuck taking a bridge.
Yeah, fuck them.
I'm going to take a paddle boat.
Fucking cunts run this country. Here we go. And then I'm getting all riled up.
Yeah, exactly. Mr. Blue is about to get a little rowdy, people.
Yeah.
But he speaks the fucking truth. I mean, really, you know, it's like... You hear about it all the time, and everyone gets pissed about it, but at the end of the day, they go to Starbucks, and they get their mocha, fucking chocolate, whatever the goddamn shit that they get, and they forget about it.
You'd rather think about other things, more important things, right? Like the coffee, like you just talked about, their mocha, chocolata, whatever the fuck.
Yeah, or what's
Starbucks.
Or what's going on in Keeping Up with the Kardashians, which I could give a fuck about.
What J-Law's doing, checking out her nude pics. I'd rather just look at that kind of shit.
I know. Just... tune the fuck out, right? It's super easy.
Yeah. Especially with the J-Law picks. I mean, that's, well, I'll look at J-Lo picks. That's really easy to get zoned out.
And I don't mind J-Lo picks. I look at those all day.
Get caught up in a nice jerk sesh with that stuff, but... I mean, even that's really fucked up. You know, I mean, that is a sex crime. I know she said it herself, right? She's quite saying it's a sex crime, because it is.
What, people jerking off their photos?
Her privacy was totally violated. Oh. And when no one cares about that... I mean, I looked at the pictures, too. I jerked off the pictures, too.
Yeah. But he's culpable as well.
But you know what? That is... The whole thing's fucked up.
Yeah, unfortunately. But like we said, people just get used to it and they're just content. Like, right now we live in a world with no privacy. And
really
people
shouldn't be.
They just don't care.
That whole thing is absolutely wrong. She was wronged. Everyone involved, everyone who was a victim of that, was wronged.
I know. It's like, how many more sex tapes and naked photos and shit have to leak that people are jerking off to before someone's like, all right, this is a serious problem. You know what I mean?
Okay, it goes back to the cloud shit we talked about a little while ago.
Yeah, your stuff is just out there, man, for everybody to see.
Fuck, enough of that shit.
Yeah, I mean, why can't a guy take an honest-to-goodness picture of his dick and not have it all over the place? I mean, what the fuck is wrong with this country?
And when you delete it, why can't it stay deleted?
Yeah, why can't it stay deleted? If I want to take a picture of my dick and have it up for a little bit and delete it, it should
I
be
want
gone.
Gone. It should be gone forever.
I mean, I'm not asking for the moon here,
no,
right?
I don't think so.
Son of a bitch.
Fucking delete the dick pics. When I want it gone, it should be gone.
Yeah, exactly. Apple, get rid of my fucking dick pics. Yeah. Get them off the cloud.
Yeah, the one I sent the Irish chick my dick wagging around, fucking get rid of that shit.
Yeah, get rid of the meat spin pictures and videos, please.
Embarrassing. If that gets released, it'll embarrass me.
Yeah, and he doesn't like to be embarrassed. So go
no,
up to
I
the
don't.
Cloud and grab that shit and pull it down.
Yeah. Throw the trash can, and I mean put in the trash can and then empty the bin. That's what I mean. Yeah. Empty the fucking bin.
I think that's a good note to end off on. Just everybody listening, empty the fucking bin.
Yeah. Make sure it's gone. Make sure the garbage man took it. It's in the
get
down
rid of
Jersey.
Your shit. Get rid of your fucking baggage, people.
Alright, is that it? Are we done here?
That's it. Fuck it. I think we're done.
They're done?
All week right. 3, it's a wrap. Miscreant, right. GrindFactor.com, Mr. Skag.
Mr. Blue again.
We will see you next week.
See you later.